This hasn't been a phrase that's been able to be used really, at least relevantly, right? I don't know why I said that like that, relevantly, in a while, but we can use it now. COD versus Battlefield. Battlefield versus Call of Duty. They've gone toe-to-toe with each other many times throughout the decades, and it's time again, my friends. The main two military FPS franchises, and with Battlefield's big comeback later this year, I thought it would be fun. Take a look back. Go through gaming history. See just how intense this rivalry has gotten over the years. That's a really hard word for me to say. So, welcome everybody. Chaos here. And I need to know which of these franchises you think is going to win 2021. Drop a like. There will be a winner. And I know, the comment section. You don't have to pick one or the other. You can be fans of both. But here's the deal. Unless you've figured out a way to play both games simultaneously, trust me when I say, EA and Activision are battling. They are battling for your precious controller time or PC time. It's happening. We're in 2021 and COD versus Battlefield is relevant once again. Thank you everybody for stopping by. Make sure you turn those notifications on. Just reply simply Call of Duty or reply Battlefield. So let's get started. COD and Battlefield both started off as PC exclusive franchises. Not everybody knew that. But they quickly started appealing to different markets. As you probably know, COD quickly took the console FPS market by storm, while Battlefield remained a PC-dominant franchise for the first two entries. Heck, it wasn't until 2005 that Battlefield even appeared on a console. But, as you probably know, both COD and Battlefield have had rather humble beginnings. They were both successes from the start, but it took until the late 2000s for them to really become the blockbusters we know, and that is where the verses really started. So if you ask me, the COD-Battlefield rivalry really kicked off in 2010, which was a pretty massive year for video games as a whole. The Xbox 360 and the PS3 were in their prime, and PC gaming was growing rapidly alongside them. In late 2009, Activision released Modern Warfare 2, which was a busted, buggy mess, but people loved it. It was crazy, over-the-top action, giant explosions, devastating killstreaks. It was a moment in gaming history that millions of people will never, ever forget, but a few months later, EA released a moment of their own called Bad Company 2. It was built on the brand new Frostbite 1.5 engine at that time. It showed off amazing visuals, crazy set pieces, exciting battles with huge landscapes, and huge lobby sizes. Now, when compared to Modern Warfare 2, Bad Company 2 appealed to a really different audience. MW2 was all about the fast-paced arcade style, crazy killstreaks, do as much damage in as little time as possible. Bad Company 2, on the other hand, it was an explosive modern military, but the pace, it was slower. It was methodical. It was much more team-focused than Modern Warfare 2, and yes, the explosions weren't as frequent, but they did a lot more damage because you could actually blow up huge portions of the map. Modern Warfare 2 and Bad Company 2 had a lot in common on the surface, but they played out very differently, and that is what kicked off. It kicked it off, people. It kicked off one of the biggest verses in gaming history. Two modern military shooters with giant player bases, but they appealed to different audiences. Now, we're used to Battlefield taking a few years in between installments, but back in the heat of this rivalry, that wasn't the case. Bad Company 2 dropped in early 2010. The following year, EA dropped Battlefield 3, which many consider to be the best in the franchise. Battlefield 3 stuck with the modern military setting and kept much of the Bad Company 2 framework intact, but they refined everything. Gunplay, smoother, more weapons, more customization, maps were fantastic, more vehicles. It was an all-around upgrade, plus EA made the sneaky decision to drop the game in October of 2011, just 1 month before Activision dropped Modern Warfare 3, which was the best-selling COD game of all time for almost a decade. Once again, the games appealed to very different audiences, despite having a lot of similarities on the surface. Modern Warfare 3, giant sales, success. It broke a bunch of media launch records. Battlefield 3 wasn't that far behind it. According to EA, Battlefield 3 was the biggest FPS launch in the company's history. It racked up 3 million pre-orders and sold another 5 million copies during the first week. And once it was all said and done and the dust settled, Battlefield 3 sold over 15 million copies, which is insane for any video game. And on the other hand, you had Modern Warfare 3 that managed to sell 26.5 million, which is nearly unheard of for any video game at that time. So when it comes to review scores, Battlefield had the edge. Modern Warfare 3 was a divisive game on launch day due to how much recycled content came from Modern Warfare 2 and how many bugs there were. Battlefield 3, it was acclaimed by critics. It was adored by fans. This showdown, it really comes down to who you ask. Modern Warfare 3 sold more copies, had a big player base, Battlefield 3 reviewed much better, and still many consider it to be the best Battlefield game ever. But things were only going to heat up. A couple years later, it's time for EA and Activision to square off again in the ring, and I think you guys already know who won this round. The year's 2013. The Xbox One and the PS4 are out. Both publishers knew they had to blow people away with their flagship FPS titles. One corner, Call of Duty Ghosts. Other corner, Battlefield 4. Now, it's worth noting, neither game had a good launch. Ghosts was ripped apart by critics and widely hated by fans, but Battlefield 4's launch was completely broken too, which really did a number on its early sales and review scores. But, as many of you know, the comeback story is big. Battlefield 4 was patched up. It still has an active player base to this day, almost 7 years later. I mean, it was once again an all-around upgrade over the previous installment. More guns, more maps, better visuals, more destruction, more content. Literally everything was improved upon from Battlefield 3, and the game was jam-packed with content. On the other hand, you had Ghosts, which many saw as the biggest misfire in COD history due to all the changes in gameplay. Slower, campier, wasn't pretty to look at. It also scrapped the fan-favorite Spec Ops and Zombie modes in favor of a sci-fi mode called Extinction, which... it was fun, but it didn't hold a candle to what came before it. Ghost managed to sell 19 million copies. That's crazy, but the reviews were bad and the multiplayer died rather quickly. Battlefield 4, on the other hand, 7 million copies in its first year on the market, and it's still getting new players to this day. Now, if you don't believe me, boot up the game and see how many people are playing. The Battlefield 2042 hype has done amazing things to Battlefield 4's player counts. And I will say, Call of Duty Ghost has aged like fine wine and cheese. A lot of people like it now, but let's keep moving. Next year was a weird one. 2015. We got Black Ops 3, many consider to be the best jetpack COD game of all time, and we got Battlefield Hardline, which, come on, it was a weird change of pace for that series, and a lot of people insist it was underrated. I don't know. Black Ops 3 is kind of like BF4 in the sense that it didn't get great reviews on launch day, but it maintained this solid player base, and that player base continued to grow over time, mainly due to it being a hands-down best COD game of the jetpack era. Hardline? Wrong place, wrong time. It was just a year and a half after Battlefield 4. Hardline, I don't know. A lot of the multiplayer was blatantly copy-pasted from BF4, and the new elements, they were divisive. EA wanted this game to be a smaller scale, more of a direct competitor to Call of Duty, but it didn't work. No means a bad game, but it didn't feel like Battlefield to a lot of people, and it didn't keep a healthy player base very long. So, while Black Ops 3 was dominating the COD scene for years, Battlefield Hardline... it faded into obscurity. It really, really did. Black Ops 3 won that battle. Let's all be honest with each other. Then we get to 2016. This is where Battlefield got its first real blowout over COD. Activision side, widely hated Infinite Warfare. EA side, widely beloved Battlefield 1. I've said before, I don't think Infinite Warfare is a bad game at all, but it was definitely the wrong place at the wrong time. People were sick of futuristic COD games, and all we wanted was a return to form. Boots on the ground. Meanwhile, EA had been paying attention to COD's moves over the last few years, and they decided to pull a fast one on them with a grounded, gritty World War One shooter. Had amazing visuals, incredible sound design, unique weaponry. I mean, you really couldn't get in any other FPS game at that time. It didn't help that Infinite Warfare's business model was ripped apart by everybody, not just for the abundance of loot boxes, but the decision to bundle COD 4 Remastered with the deluxe version of the game forced you to drop $80 if you wanted to play COD 4 again. Infinite Warfare ended up being the worst-selling COD in over a decade. It sold less than half of Black Ops 3. Meanwhile, Battlefield 1, 15 million smooth copies, some of the best numbers in franchise history. Now, many players have their issues with BF1 compared to other entries in the series, but it's undeniable that EA came out swinging and they won this round. But did they keep the ball rolling? Well, the next Battlefield game was 2018, and to put it simply, this is the reason why Battlefield got put on the shelf. Battlefield 5 was a return to World War II, but there were so many missteps along the way here. The marketing was atrocious. Some of the design decisions, questionable, okay? And the gameplay was heavily simplified from previous installments to the point it was honestly unbalanced. DICE was also constantly making these sweeping changes to things like weapon balance, time to kill, all while failing to make up for the severe lack of content the game had on launch day. Then again, 2018 gave us Black Ops 4, which... that's a polarizing game in its own right. It is. Black Ops 4 was boots on the ground, but a lot of changes to the formula. Longer time to kill, manual healing, reduction in team sizes. Overall, neither side really had a lot to offer. But Black Ops 4 ended up stomping Battlefield 5 because Battlefield 5 was constantly getting itself into hot water. BO4, cruising along, staying out of trouble. Well, kinda. The Black Ops pass. Anyway, Black Ops 4 certainly had a fair share of controversies, but compared to BF5, nah. DICE and EA, let's just be real, they pissed off too many people with Battlefield 5 and they completely abandoned the game altogether just a couple years later, putting Battlefield on the shelf. And that allowed Activision to run free and dominate the FPS market with Modern Warfare 2019 and Black Ops Cold War. So what happens now, my friends? Well, Battlefield is returning to modern combat with 2042. We know this. While Activision, they're doing something. We really don't know. We have ideas. We have rumors that COD 2021 is going to be COD Vanguard, set in World War II time, but maybe alternate history. I don't know. Some people call me a COD insider. I don't know. I'm not going to make a stance either way yet. Warzone is doing tremendous, but a lot of players have been leaving due to the abundance of hackers and design flaws and the lack of competition. Well, it's put COD in a weird place because there's so many problems with Call of Duty today, but due to the lack of competition, you can go, right? But things change soon. Battlefield returning. Hype through the roof. Activision has to bring their A game or they're going to get dethroned like they were in 2016. COD 2021 has to be amazing. Warzone needs to get a lot of additional support or else the door is open. It's open for EA to go in and run circles around them. It really is. I don't know. Who's going to win? We're going to have to wait and see. And one thing is for sure. 2021 is going to be a very interesting year for the FPS fans. And in the end, I ultimately hope who wins is you and me. It's the fans of both IPs, both franchises, because I feel like they're both going to put their best foot forward. And in the end, competition breeds success, and it gives us, the consumer, a better product. Let me know what you think, guys. COD versus Battlefield. Here we go.